This is a video on my programs and how they are applied to the TI-89 titanium calculator, programmed for that calculator. And today I'm doing a video on limits, in particular when a limit is undefined. And let's get started. In my main menu, you have to get to it by pressing second alpha and press the letters INDEX, and then press alpha again, put the 8 in the open and close parentheses, and then press enter, and you're into my menu. There's many things, as you can see, in this menu. It goes all the way down, scrolls all the way up or down. Parametric equations, log of x, many, many things for you to pass calculus and do your homework. Right now, we're going to do limits. Let me scroll to that. We have several options in the limits. And the table of limits is when they have you on a test put a table down, and on each side of the approaching point to get the limit. And I do that for you too here, but right now we're going to just compute a limit. And we have to press alpha before we enter any function in my entry lines here of my programs, but let's put the function in for the numerator, x cubed minus 7. Close off the parentheses, divided by the denominator. Always use plenty of parentheses. X squared minus 4. As x approaches 2, alpha 2. I show you what you've entered. You can change it if you've made a mistake, but this is x cubed minus 7 for the numerator and x squared minus 4 as x approaches 2. Right away, I compute the denominator and it turns out to be 0, so that makes the function undefined. So now our job is to find the limit of that point where it's undefined. So we increase the point by 1/100th and put it into your function. You put this stuff exactly like you said on your, like it is here on your paper or homework. And you're just substituting that number 2.01 for x in every value of the function. And I show you what that computes out to do, and then you can get an A on this problem. Limit is 27.9. Pretty neat, huh? Everystepcalculus.com. Go to my programs, enjoy my programs, and pass calculus.